Good afternoon, everyone. This is your very good home neighbor, Nicky, confusing to another Tanada fans that are you. And welcome to another amazing video. And I really hope you enjoy my movie review of Avatar The Way of Water, because after I saw that movie in theaters in 3D, it's honestly one of my, best 3-hour movies I ever seen, next to The Avengers Endgame and this movie in Return of the King. Yep, ladies and gentlemen, this movie, it's another 3-hour movie. Man, we are getting some bunch of 3-hour movie. First, we got The Batman. Second, we got Wakanda Forever. Third, we got The RRR, which I haven't seen that movie, but that movie will not be in my top 10 best film of the year. So sorry to disappoint you people, but I'm not going to waste my time watching some 3-hour action movies. So yeah, I am taking a break watching some 3-hour movie because after I watched Avatar 2 and Babylon, people, I need to take a break watching 3-hour movie. So I hope you guys understand that. So anyway, guys, so today I'm doing a movie review on my last film I'm gonna watch in 2022 before the New Year's Day gonna come up, which is other than Babylon, starring Brad Pitt, Margot Robbie, and Tobey Maguire. All right, came out of 2022, because this film is gonna be the last film I am going to watch for this year. But I will watch Puss in Boots, The Last Wish, and The Whale, and some 2022 movie that it will be not in my list. So yeah, maybe next year. And so, hey guys, so after I watched this movie on HE Today CET, because I was planning to do a review of this movie when the movie's over, but apparently my power just went off, so, guys, I have to wait for a couple hours until my power come on, and here we are right now. Power just came on, and now that's why I'm doing the review of this movie. And so, hey guys, so after I watched this movie at HE Today CC, which is a website you could watch some free movies on the new movies, and what I think about this film, well, even this film has some, I have some commercial break about that darn money crap, but this film is an epic, brilliant masterpiece, and this is hands down one of my number 10 best film of the year. Because honestly, I was originally going to wait until this movie coming on digital in 2023 on January or February. But honestly, I'm not going to waste my time waiting for 2023. So that's why I'll watch this film earlier. And so, hey guys, this is easily one of the second best film that... sorry. And honestly, this is easily one of the second best film that he ever directed, because La La Land will always be my favorite film from the director who made La La Land and Babylon. And so, hey guys, do I have any problem about this movie? Any criticism about this movie? No, I don't have any problem about this movie. Because even this movie is insane, it's crazy, and it's really raunchy. But this film has some incredible story, a love of characters, and some score is honestly one of the best score of the year, because that score is so insane, so crazy, and it makes you want to party! So, hey guys, now let's talk about how crazy this movie is. Hey, just because this movie crazy didn't mean it's a bad thing. So yeah, let's talk about how crazy this movie is. The story is really awesome, because I really enjoyed the story, because I really... I really like the story when this movie takes place in Hollywood in the 30s, so I really enjoy that story. And the characters, I really love every single character. My favorite character of this film, it had to be Margot Robbie's character. This is hands down one of the best performances I ever seen from Margot Robbie, next to her character from Amsterdam. Because Margot Robbie, she's so beautiful in this one. Because honestly, this is the best Margot Robbie character I ever seen, next to the Suicide Squad 2021 Harley Quinn. No, not 2016 Harley Quinn. I'm talking about the 2021 Harley Quinn. And Brad Pitt. Honestly, for Brad Pitt character, honestly, even he's an okay actor, he's not the best, but this is hands down one of the best performances I ever seen, because honestly, I really like his character development, I really like his characters. And honestly, guys, and that one dude over there who hang out with Margot Robbie so much, honestly, he's a really great character. It's not the best character of this movie, but honestly, he's a really awesome character. And that one character, and that one black dude who played the instrumental for the soundtrack, honestly, he's a really awesome character. And honestly, the last character for this film is had to be Tobey Maguire's character. Honestly, I don't understand why some people think Tobey Maguire is not in this movie. Well, it takes forever that Tobey Maguire is in this movie. Yep, Tobey Maguire from Spider-Man movies, from Spider-Man No Way Home, is in this movie. Because after we've seen a PG-13, and now this is the very first rated R film that Tobey Maguire ever in. So that's pretty impressive. And sorry guys, and the cinematography is so beautiful. I really love the cinematography of the film. And the climax of the film is pretty insane. This is honestly one of the most insane climax I've ever seen in my life. And the ending, I really enjoy the ending of the film. The ending of the film is really iconic and really amazing. So over guys, I'm just to say about this film, because honestly, I don't understand why this movie bombed the box office, because honestly guys, the main reason why this movie bombed the box office, and no people, is not because Puss in Boots: The Last Wish, so I'm not blaming that movie. Honestly guys, the main reason why this movie bombed the box office so hard, it has to be the snowstorm. Honestly, Paramount, I'm not hating on you, but why in the world you release this film on the day that we have the snowstorm? Yeah, this is the main reason why people did not see this movie, and people want to wait until on digital. But hey people, if you don't feel like watching this movie in theaters, I recommend you wait on digital, or heck, you can just watch in the ATTACC, that's what we have it in the first place. Except going in the theater, you can just, you can just watch this. And Avatar: The Way of the Water, that's a different story. That is the most rewatchable movie theaters ever. So, I recommend you watch Avatar 2 in theaters and watch this movie, because this movie is like a blockbuster movie. So, you guys, I'm probably this film and Amsterdam are two of the biggest box office bombs so hard. Because first, Amsterdam bombed the box office so hard, and now we got this movie bombed the box office hard just because they have a big old casting. So you guys, and I cannot believe why Geeko Gamer thinks this movie woke just because it got bombed the box office. No, that's not the reason. The reason why is because we got a snowstorm. Not how woke this movie is, and people need to stop using woke, because it's really getting freaking annoying sometime. So over guys, Babylon, this is easily one of my number 10 best film of the year. Thank God I watched this film, and this is the with you gentlemen, this film is the last film I'm gonna watch in 2022. And tonight I will rewatch Jurassic World Dominions on DVD, or maybe tomorrow or Saturday, but I don't know, or maybe next year. So Honestly, I might rewatch Jurassic World Dominion. Maybe see my opinion would change. Who knows? No tough to tell, because I keep seeing Dominion on everyone's worst film of the year. So honestly, seriously, people, is Jurassic World Dominion is that bad? It's not bad. Honestly, we saw way worse movie from this year, like Morbius, Super Pet, Crocodile. All three film are way worse, and even Halloween Ends, that movie is way worse than Jurassic World Dominions. So, hey guys, I am giving Babylon a 10 out of 10. That's an epic, brilliant masterpiece. And I am giving this insane film a seal of nitpick awesomeness. Well, guys, this is it. This is the last film I'm going to watch in 2022. And my movie review of Everything Everywhere at Once, even on... sorry, need some water, man. Need some water for this one, so sorry. Back I was saying. Well, guys, this is the last film I'm gonna watch in 2022. It's had been a fun ride that we did a review of a movie that I've seen this year. First, I seen all the film, including Deep Water. Yes, people, I'm very sorry I didn't do a review of Deep Water. So I might review that maybe the beginning of January or February or March. I don't know, time to tell, because maybe I could do a review of Deep Water on the first anniversary. So stay tuned. Yup, it's kind of sad that 2022 is coming to an end. Well, guys, 2023 is coming, so get ready for my new channel, get ready for my new rule, and get ready for my channel update. So hey guys, so if you like this very raunchy video, please, I recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn on notification, and share with your whole family. So this film is pretty insane. Honestly, I'm proud this film is not for everyone. Honestly, people, just because this film is so crazy, didn't mean this movie's for you. honestly, this film is for everyone who's a fan of these kind of movie. But honestly, if you're not a fan of this kind of movie, just don't watch it. Use your common sense, okay? Good. And honestly, kid, do not watch this film. Go watch Puss in Boots: The Last Wish. Go watch What You. Go watch any kids movie more than this one, because this movie is too dirty for this one. Sorry. And sorry, guys. And hey, just because I'm 21, it didn't mean I'm... honestly, just because I'm 21, it didn't mean I will do whatever I want. Because my mom said that before, because honestly, guys, at the end of the day, you gotta be careful what you're getting on, you gotta be careful what you're doing, because Marcus told me yesterday, but that's okay, you can do some stuff, but just don't send it to everyone. So I might do that video next year for the reason, so you cannot hide something, because your parent knows everything. Like mom know everything what I did. So you gotta be good, gotta be family friendly. Just honestly, just because this movie's not family friendly, didn't mean this movie is family friendly. So don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, don't worry, boys and girls. This review is for family friendly. So yeah. And sorry, guys. So if you like this video, then Margot Robbie's Acolyte of Acolyte's The Craziness, please, I recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn the notification, and share it with your whole family. So get ready for Tommy Bagrell smiling in this movie. Yup, that's my impression of Tommy Bagrell character from Barry On. Which is the second best character that Tobey Maguire ever did, because him as Peter Parker will be the best character that Tobey Maguire ever did, and Tobey Maguire is such a legend. Sorry guys, I see you next time. It's all Marcus Feature Truth. Have a great day. Have a great afternoon, everyone. Stay tuned for my top 10 best and worst movie of the year video, and I see you guys next time, and have a great afternoon. See you guys next time.
You're sweating.
Nah.